If you have ever tried to learn any foreign language, then I'm sure you have asked yourself the question, which level should I even try to aim for? How long should I learn the language? I mean, when do I really know it? And how far should I try to get, right? I think these are very relevant questions. And there is also one more question which people don't usually ask themselves, but it is really, really important. And the question is, how long will it take me to forget what I have learned and to get back to zero? How long will it take me to lose the language that I've learned? And if you have ever learned a language and you don't speak the language as fluently and comfortably as you would like to, even though you have spent quite some time learning it, then I'm sure this video will tell you why that is, because there are different levels of learning a language and there are different rules as to how long it takes to get there and how long it takes to also forget it, unfortunately. So that's what this video will be about. I got inspired to shoot this video when a friend of mine approached me last week and she said, "Lydia, I'm excited to learn Italian and I know you help people learn languages, so please tell me, what should I do? Because I'm going to go to Italy on business, I'm going to go to some, I don't know, some institutions and try to achieve something, and I don't want to pay an interpreter, I want to, you know, just do it by myself. So I have a month and I want to learn Italian, what should I do?" And I was really surprised to hear her even ask that question, because it's absurd. You cannot do that. You cannot learn a new language within 1 month to the level that you can actually do some legal stuff in that language, and it just doesn't work like that. So I see that people have very unreasonable expectations when it comes to language learning, and that's why I want to clarify it in this video. By the way, if you don't know me, my name is Lydia Machová. I'm from Slovakia. I'm a polyglot. I learn a new language every 2 years. Currently, I speak 7 languages fluently and 2 more on not so fluent level. I'll explain in the video why. And with my project Language Mentoring, I teach people how they can learn any language by themselves, because I believe this is the most efficient way anyway. So let's go through those 4 levels. Let's start with the very basic one, the easiest one. That's what I call a travel level. This is only used for travel purposes. For example, you're going on holiday to a country like Italy and you want to learn some basic phrases just to get by, you know? This is a very easy thing to achieve in a language. It doesn't take much time and you will not understand a lot from the language. This is very important to realize, to have proper expectations. What you need to do is just to get a book of conversational phrases, travel phrases. There are a lot of books like that. And to pick the ones that are relevant to you. So don't just try to learn a language with Duolingo or another app where, you know, it's in a fun way, you play around with some words, but really try to pick the words which you will really need on your holiday. Maybe it's relevant for you to book accommodation in the language, maybe not. Maybe you want to ask about the directions, or maybe not. Maybe you have Google Maps, you know. So really make sure that you pick the phrases which are relevant to you. Write them down in a list and try to go through that list over and over and over again. If you know how to use flashcards or something like that, that's even better. But if you just want to, you know, just play around a little bit with the phrases, then just read them over and over again, try to pronounce them. And have the right expectations, which means don't expect that you will be able to say a phrase and the other person replies and you will be able to understand them. It doesn't work like that. Now, let's say you go to a shop and you ask, "How much does this cost?" right? Which is quite a useful phrase to learn. Now, the other person can just reply, you know, four euros or dollars, and then you will know, you know, you had a successful conversation. Congratulations, that's a great feeling. But the other person can also say something more complicated, like, "Oh, you know what, we have it on discount now because last week we actually ran out of stock with these things, but actually, you know what, I'll give it to you for a special price," and they can go on and on and on, and you will not be able to understand them. And this is perfectly fine, okay, because you are just on the travel level. And you have just learned a few phrases and you have learned how you will say them. You have not learned how to understand everything else from the language because you haven't spent time actually working on improving your listening comprehension. I hope that makes sense, because I see that many people have very, very absurd expectations, I would say. They think that when they spend, I don't know, 2 weeks on Duolingo, that they will somehow understand a conversation, but it just doesn't work like that, okay? So this is the travel level. You can achieve it within, I would say, 2 to 4 weeks If you spend 20-30 minutes with it a day, you can learn enough phrases to actually go to the country and use it. Of course, it depends. If you just want to learn 5 basic words, then you need 5 minutes and that's it. Go and enjoy. The second level is what I call the, I would say, orientation level or basic level. This is when you have the basics in the language and you can orient yourself in the language, meaning that you start to understand how the language works and you actually understand a bit from what you hear or see or read, what people tell you. This is a level, the first one, for those of you who know the European framework, that was the A1 level. Now, this basic or orientation level is between A2 and B1, okay? And on this level, you can read a text or someone speaks to you and you actually understand what they talk about, but you don't quite understand what's going on. So you cannot have a proper, easy conversation without any effort. And you probably have to ask the other person to slow down, to say it again, to repeat, you know, to make sure that you understand. And again, this is perfectly fine on this level because you have spent less time learning the language. Now, how much should that be? It depends on many, many, many things. It depends on what is your mother tongue, what language you're learning, how many other languages you know, what levels you have in those languages, many, many things. But to roughly give an estimate, I would say it takes between 1 month and 1 year to be in this basic level where you can actually understand what's going on and try to feel like, okay, I'm starting to get this language. I don't quite have it yet, I don't quite own it, but I'm starting to get there. And with this level, if you learn it, the negative news here is that unfortunately you will forget it or forget a bit of it unless you get to the third level. I will explain this at the end, I will get back to this. The third level is the best one, it's my favorite one, and it's the one that I aim for in learning all my languages. It's what many polyglots and people call the comfortable fluency level. In the European framework, this is called, this is the B2, but I mean a solid, good B2 level where you don't have to think about the language anymore, you just use it in everyday situations, right? You can watch a movie, you can read a book, you can talk to a stranger, and the stranger doesn't need to slow down or speak more clearly. They speak normally and you react normally. You can reply fluently without any problems. It doesn't mean that you don't make any mistakes. This is not the goal. It's perfectly fine if you make mistakes or if your pronunciation, you know, if you have some accent or if you don't know some words, it's perfectly fine. But you can use the language comfortably. This is the most important thing. And I think this should be the goal for everyone learning a language. Because with this level, the best thing is that you will not lose it if you stop using it. I have a metaphor which I love to use to explain this. Have you seen the movie Cast Away with Tom Hanks from 2000? It's a great movie, hope you watched it. If not, a guy is left stranded on an island and tries to get away by building a little boat, right? And the thing is, he tries to get away by going across the waves which are around the island. But at the beginning it's easy, he can get over those waves. But then he gets to the final big wave and he cannot get over it. And that's why he is left there for many years, because the big wave always crushes him and drags him back towards the island. And this is exactly what happens with language learning if you don't cross that last wave, which is the comfortable fluency, the B2 level. If you just learn the language a little bit and then you stop learning, the waves drag you back towards the island. Then you start learning again, so you wander out again, but then you don't quite make it to the last level and the waves drag you back. And that's why many people are stuck on the second level, it seems forever, you know, for many, many years. And that's why many people then think, oh, I'm not talented, I don't have the language gene, I cannot learn a language. But the problem actually is you haven't got far enough in the language, and that's why you will always lose it and forget it. This is what happened to me with Swahili, for example. It was my last language which I was learning. I got it to this basic orientation level where I was on the B1, starting to get to B2, and I started to feel pretty good in that language. But I didn't make it over that last wave. I never got it to a level where I would be just comfortable speaking it and reading anything and listening. So when I didn't use it for, let's say, 9 months, then I met someone, a Swahili speaker from Kenya, and I couldn't say almost anything. I lost it. That's how long it takes you to lose a language when you're on the second level. Now with the third level, you don't really lose it. I mean, of course, you get it in a more active state or a more passive state, but the good thing is you can spend several months or even years not using that language. And then when someone gets by, a native speaker of that language, you slowly get back into it, and within a few hours, maybe, 2 or 3 days, you're absolutely back at that comfortable fluency level and you can use it again. So I think this is why language learning to up to this level really pays off, because you don't really lose the time spent if you just learned a language to a small level, like a little bit of basic, because you will lose it right away. Now that we talk about losing the language, I forgot to mention the first level, the travel level. It will only take you maybe a month or, I don't know, half a year tops to forget what you've learned. And it seems like, oh my God, this is wasted. Like, I've spent so much time learning it, like a month learning the language, and now it's gone. And that's because those were the first waves, right? And you were dragged back towards the island, you're on the level zero and you can start over again. So that's a bit ungrateful about learning a language. But that's exactly why I really, really encourage people to try to get it over that last wave, because then you will not lose it. And now let's have a look at the final stage, the fourth level, which is what I call the professional level. In the European framework, this is the C1 or C2, which is a level where you can really use the language professionally as a translator, interpreter, or let's say you do some business negotiations in that language, you write legal letters where the person who reads it cannot tell if you're a native speaker or not. It really is really, really good. You know all the nuances of the language. Grammar is like no problem. You know all the details and all the exceptions. And most of all, your vocabulary is really, really wide. And not just in your area of expertise or your everyday life, but you also have very wide and rich vocabulary in many other areas. Let's say agriculture, IT, legal, anything really, medicine, right? So this is a level which I personally think is not necessary for most people. And I see that many people are trying to move up the ladder a little bit more. They got to the B2 and they think, okay, now I definitely need to get to the C1 and C2. But actually, I don't think this is necessary. I think the B2 level, the comfortable fluency level, is the best level to have, and of course you can improve it and grow your vocabulary. You can learn a bit more about grammar, although you probably have the basic grammar covered by then. But it's not really necessary for you to try to achieve that level. I personally studied English and German; those are my professional languages. So I got to the C1, C2 level, and it's a lot of work, right? So when we said that the travel level takes about 2 to 4 weeks, the orientation or basic level takes about 1 month to 1 year, roughly. Again, roughly, depending on many, many, many variables. Now the comfortable fluency level usually takes about 1 year to 3 years. And by that, I mean when you spend about 1 hour a day learning that language. That for me is the recipe to learning all the languages that I've learned. It usually takes me a year and a half. I do it every 2 years, so I always have some pauses in between, or some weeks or months where I don't learn actively. And this is perfectly fine for me to keep the language and move on to the next one, because I know I will not lose the one which I have learned. Now the fourth level, the professional level, takes a bit longer. And this is also, again, very important to realize if you are trying to achieve that level. It will take you a few years to really learn the vocabulary from all possible areas. So it doesn't work like okay, I spent 3 months with A1 and then 3 months with A2 and then 3 months with B1. It doesn't work like that. I know that a lot of language schools or courses present it this way, but I personally don't believe it. And I've discussed this with a lot of polyglots in polyglot events that I organized or attended, and we agree that the B2 level is kind of the best one to have, and also the one where for most people the language learning journey can stop, or of course you can use the language but not try to get it to the next level. So I hope this has helped in some ways, and hopefully now that you have heard this, you will understand why this friend of mine who approached me, who wanted to learn Italian in 1 month, trying to achieve a level where she can use the language almost professionally, I hope you understand now why it's absurd. It really doesn't work like that. So I hope that has helped. And by the way, if you would like to learn how to learn a language to get over that last wave and how to make it fun and effective at the same time, then definitely check out my website, languagementoring.com. We organize online courses where we help people do that in a way which suits them, which is fun, which is enjoyable, where language learning becomes part of your lifestyle, and where you can really, really get over that last wave so that all your language learning effort wasn't in vain. So I hope to see you there. If you have any comments, please let me know below the video, and see you in the next video. Bye.